Don't you think it's kind of strange? How sometimes when you wake up, you know you had a dream, but you can't remember it. Where do you suppose those dreams go? But there's one dream I remember very clearly, as if it was happening right now.
Hello everyone and welcome to my walkthrough of Klonoa on the Wii, a Wii remake of the PlayStation 1 game titled Klonoa Door to Phantom Isle, and let's get it started. I intend on 100%ing the game as usual, and by 100%ing I mean beating all the stages and rescuing all the captured villagers, of which I'll get into a little later. These gems, green ones are worth 1, blue ones are worth 5, collect 100, you'll get a 1-up. And that's really pretty much all there is to these gems. It's very easy, and you'll notice that... Wait, what was that egg in the background there? Well, if you look at the sign... Well, I didn't mean to lose the guy, dang it! If you use the control pad, you can press up to face, yeah, inward and outward, you know, up and down like so. And yeah, that's how you interact with stuff in the background. And you can press the one button to grab enemies and throw them at stuff into the background and the foreground. So it's not just like a pure side-scrolling game, it's definitely full 3D in a side-scrolling world, so that gives you a lot of unique gameplay elements. See this thingy right here? See this thingy? Pop it. That is a captured villager, and the number of them in each stage varies. See this? Remember that. Now, over here is another sign which will teach you how to jump when carrying a captured enemy. This is the double jump, per se. I've already sort of showed this in a... Yeah. So yeah, you already kind of know that as well. This clock right here is a checkpoint, so if you die, you'll start off where you left off, and yeah, that should be pretty obvious. These little gusts of wind there just push you up, that's all there is to it, and there's another captured villager. Must collect them all, yeah! Big jump here, just make sure you just hold the jump button, you'll make that gap easily, actually. There's no real worry about that whatsoever. Jumping guys? I don't know the name of any enemy in this game unless it's told to me in the game's storyline. It's not even clear in the instruction booklet. I don't see them anywhere in the instruction booklet, so I am completely at a loss.
Hold up there a minute, you guys!
Okay.
Up here! I'm up here!
Pan that camera.
got something I need to ask you guys. I'll be right down, so just hang on for a sec.
Okay, this should... Oh! I thought it was going to take a while, but that's definitely not going to. What's the point of ladders if he can jump like that? Same, I think. Indeed, we've seen it in the cutscene. I told you to remember that little sculpture. Okay, it's not little.
You kids today got no culture.
But it is pretty epic. I mean, it's carved right out of the mountain face.
Oh, she is amazing. And you know, since Lafice lives in the legendary Moon Kingdom, I'm building this tower so I can get there and visit.
You really think it'll reach
What are your intents, man? This is getting... Oh dear. Yeah, this is getting a little frightening, actually. Smell you later. See, what is the point of ladders? Anyway, let's move on. By the way, to enter doors, you just press up. Yeah. checkpoints! Must get... Oh. Not O's. I must get the captured villagers. We must save everyone! And take this path. You'll notice that there is a split path over there. This will lead to a dead end, which will loop you back to that junction. But don't worry. This is definitely worth it because of a couple of captured villagers. And these enemies right here, just... You can't really do anything about them. You can't even throw things at them. By the way, hear that? You can actually hit your head on the top of there and it'll make a sound. I always found that a little bit funny that they add such a detail into it. By the way, you'll see in the background there's a silver coin. Those silver coins are 1-ups. There's also gold coins, which are worth 3. The silvers are 1. Checkpoint up here. Woo! See that life counter on the right side there? Yeah. And going back. And we're here. At least, yeah, we're here at the junction. That fairy right there will double the amount of gems that you get per collect. Like, I mean, per gem that you collect. If that makes... Yeah, that should make sense. What am I trying to over-describe things for? It's times 2 multiplier, jeez. And this one you don't have to press up at all to get through, but... Oh, there we go. And I will indeed save the game here. I intend on doing one level per video, just to keep it organized, just like what I did in Super Monkey Ball 2. And see the 6 villagers that are now down there that are rescued. There's when you see 6 underneath a level, it means that you have completed the level 100%. No matter how many of the villagers are actually strewn about the level, there will always be 6 on this map screen here. And the more villagers that you have on the screen, the more dynamic this song that you hear on the map screen is, as well as the unlockables that you'll get for collecting a bunch of them. So don't worry, it will be worth collecting all of them in the end. And I actually never 100% of this game before, so I'm kind of doing this Zelda Ocarina of Time style, where I am, where I've beat the game before but never 100%ed it, and now I'm doing it in the walkthrough, that sort of thing, because I figured it worked pretty well with Ocarina of Time, well, Master Quest, and so I thought, yeah, let's try it here. And for some reason, it seems to tell you your high score of how many gems you have that you collected on each level. See that 145 that I have on the... Yeah. Well, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I will see you in the next part when we do Vision 1-2.